Okay, so in the previous lab, we just here done the SNAT. There were two step process actually. So first of all, we created the SNAT pool list. In the SNAT pool list, we have created three IP. These are three IP we added. Then we went to SNAT list. And in the SNAT list, we called the pool. And as a result, we tested it and everything is working. We tested the IP request is coming from this IP. Now let's just do one thing. I'm just going to use the delete the SNAT, for example, this list. And let's see what happened. And when I try to use this, so you see the request is now changed to 200.165.100. So as a result, this communication can be broken. But what we can do is we need to do one more thing. So basically, we can based on our this topology, this lab, actually, we are creating SNAT inside virtual server. So rather than using the SNAT in the SNAT list, we created a pool. Pool is required, but rather than calling them in the SNAT list, we can use this into the virtual server configuration. So the steps would be, is if you go to the steps actually, first of all, creating a pool. So pool is already created. Then we go into the HTTP virtual server. MAZ HTTP virtual server, where is that? MAZ HTTP virtual, yeah, this one, 100. And the inside the virtual server, there is the SNAT. So it will be source address translation. So basically, you need to go here, all VLAN and tunnel, source address translation. By default, it was none. So you will be saying SNAT pool. This is the pool you have already created, and then you update it. So basically, now this time when you hit to 200.1.100, okay? For the testing reason, log into machine again. I'm logging to the 100. And let's see where the request is coming from. Okay, client IP. So you can see this client IP is this. If I just remove this, for example, you can try to remove this SNAT, just you say none. Without none, you will be able to see that the request is coming from the my test machine. Okay, so request normally comes from the without that NAS. You applied a VIP on the HTTP request is coming from here. But with the SNAT configuration, okay, SNAT pool. Right? This time when I test this again, the request is coming from, sorry, have we applied? Let's see. I haven't updated yet. What happened? Oh, sorry, this one. Yeah, now you see 1.12. So any IP address which is available in the pool. And that's how you test it. So there is another test methods are also provided in this document. So please follow this. You can see SNAT translation. You can check in this in the stats, LTM, local traffic, SNAT translation. There's 11, 12 acre series. Okay. So that's the configuration of SNAT using the virtual IP. Okay. Thank you.